So therefore, that is very clear in what Jawor reveals in 1 Corinthians in that particular chapter and in those verses. Now, my point is a lot of Christians will take advantage of, or so-called Christians, so-called Christians will take advantage of newly born believers or seekers in the true path, manipulating the actual scripture for what it truly says or what it truly reveals. Saying that, well, this is why in a Bible study, being pretending to be the head of that particular study, this is why we should not masturbate. And at that point, this was over 11 or 12 years ago, I was like, what? This is why we should not masturbate. Now, nowhere in that scripture or anywhere in Jah Word does it say you shall not masturbate. As a matter of fact, masturbation is a very natural thing for all people. We all know that. Okay, it's not that, when you really, like the first messianic apostles and, first messianic disciples and first century, true Christians, and even today, well, true Christian and Rastafari and, all those in the true messianic faith, when you really become alive in the spirit through a period of days or a couple of days or weeks where, there's serious prayer, a serious meditation and fasting and, really being alive in the spirit through witnessing and prophecies. Yeah, I mean, through the Holy Spirit and the powers of the Most High Jah, one can go without, actual masturbation, but nowhere in Jah word from the original commandments to say thou shall not masturbate. It says thou shall not commit adultery. Okay, and yeah, even the true Christ and the true Messiah, Yeshua, Jesus spoke of adultery of the heart. When the Messiah spoke of these things and these teachings, he was actually making a point. He was making a good point to his followers in that time, as it was meant to be written, even Yah willing, as it is today in the gospels of Yeshua, Jesus Christ. But I mean, he's making a point about our spiritual adultery from the heart. Granted, if we have a best friend or a so-called brother who's got a wife or a girlfriend in a serious relationship, okay, don't, try to guard your heart a little bit. We're all sexual beings. Okay, Almighty God, Elohim, our Heavenly Father made us to be sexual beings, both men and women alike. Both men and women alike are sexual beings. There's no doubt about that. That's natural, even according to the Father's will. Sexuality itself is meant to be a pure, beautiful thing and a blessing. However, of course, Satan likes to, he likes to pervert and distort things. So therefore, prostitution is unlawful. Fornication, as well as, is very unclean. Paying money for actual sex, that becomes, that was Christ's teachings and accuracy as far as, committing adultery within the heart. But actual adultery is actually committing adultery, being unfaithful to one's spouse, whether it be, husband or wife, boyfriend or girlfriend. When two people make a covenant with each other, or an agreement, an official agreement with each other, that they are boyfriend and girlfriend, husband and wife, no matter how long the relationship lasts, you have to be faithful. That was the true Christ teachings, the true Messiah's teachings, and fulfillment of the original Torah of Jah Word. And so modern corporate Christianity will take actual facts and even divine scripture and twist it around to put people in a mental bondage, such as do not masturbate, do not fornicate, do not smoke or drink alcohol, do not curse, as a kind of a mental slave grip over somebody, to where they feel like they don't have an actual connection with the Father or a direct connection with the Father through Christ, the true Christ. Just like that satanic influence, legalistic doctrine, such as, well, one has to go to the high priest or the Catholic priest, to get clear answers from Almighty God. You have to go to the Catholic priest and confession and all this stuff. No, you can go anywhere in the world, at your local church, if it's a true Christian church body, in your home, in your house, in your room, in your car, and confess to the one true God, the Most High Jah, in the true Messiah, in the true Christ, in Yeshua's name, and be heard, you know, have direct access to the Father. So let's get these things straight. Masturbation is a natural thing. As a matter of fact, it speaks of in the Quran that once a disciple relieves themselves, you know, they're permitted to wash their hands if they're out in the wilderness or on a voyage throughout the desert to use sand and purification before daily prayer and meditation, okay? Masturbation is a natural thing. We live in a world today, and I'm not rationalizing. People think, oh, he's rationalizing. No, I'm speaking the truth because this serves as a mental bondage for my, even my true born-again brothers and sisters in the kingdom or in Christ. For example, not that fellow Christian brothers raised up with this so-called bondage mentality of spirituality and Christianity, where they think, you know, I really, I'm just beating myself up, man. You know, I'm trying to live right, but I'm addicted to pornography, man. I'm just addicted to pornography, you know, masturbating to porn and stuff I shouldn't look at, you know. And, but yet, it becomes superstitious in the sense to where, you know, I think maybe I lost my job or I got these health problems because I was looking at porn, you know. And I'm thinking, well, what about what you just told me in the previous week about, you know, making out with that girl last weekend, you know, when you have a girlfriend still, you know, you have an official girlfriend, you've been in this official relationship for the past couple of years, like, what about that? That's actual adultery, my friend, just because you're not legalistically married. In a modern, you know, Christendom would say, well, I thought adultery was just when you're married and you're supposed to wait until marriage. Now, that, you know, even so-called Christians would use that as a guilt trip. Like, granted, you know, it is relevant, you know, it is relevant to wait until marriage. If one can wait and keep their virginity until marriage, you know, even I support that in the fullness. I support that because that's the most pure, you know, righteous way. You know, I'm speaking from my own perspective right now because, you know, as a witness myself, for the time being, I'm not married. You know, I don't have an official long-term relationship or a long-term girlfriend right now. I'm just kind of dating different women, different girls, you know, from time to time, just when I can, you know. You know, if I could find the righteous one, and I try to slow my roll down. I don't put myself out in the world and get caught up in debauchery and sleeping with too many different women at one time. I don't do that. I don't feel like that's a clean lifestyle. That's like the actual true Christ or true, you know, messianic teachings, you know, not to be too caught up in the world system. But however, at the same time, if one can wait and be strong enough in today's world system to wait for such a pure, perfect thing and have ultimate faith in the Most High, as we all should, then I congratulate that in the fullness. But to put a bondage over somebody at the same time, like, well, you have to wait until marriage and you have to choose somebody, and granted, we have to be equally yoked. As it says in the word in 1 Corinthians, we have to be equally yoked with somebody who's born again in the kingdom, in Christ. But when you have a particular church talking about, well, it has to be at this particular church body or this particular denomination of our church because this is the true Christian church and you have to be dipped in water and baptized in our church to be fully saved and born again. And you have to, that's a cult, man. That's false doctrines. That's almost blasphemy of the ultimate truth. And you got to stay away from those cult-like so-called Christian church bodies. You know, have love for them, forgive them, know that someday, hopefully, we'll all be in the kingdom of heaven and the resurrection upon earth when heaven returns to the earth, the true Christ, our Lord and Savior, the true Messiah revealed in his glory, you know, in due time, the King of Kings, you know, as he's already made that revelation through the King of Kings, but in the third coming and fourth coming in the restoration of the earth, and some refer to the actual second coming, you know, eventually in due time, you know, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess in due time, but,